Hey there, welcome back to the English Literature, your go-to destination for all things literary. In the previous video, you have navigated the vast sea of the MG 7 syllabus with me. And now it's time to chart a course for your exam success. I promised you a roadmap and today we are diving into block 1 of MG 7. But hold on tight because we are not just scratching the surface. We are going to unveil the secrets hidden in the questions that have echoed through this block over the last decade. So ready? Let's set sail. Here comes Unit 1, which is Addresses at the Parliament of Religions by Swami Vivekanand, and these are the questions asked from this unit in the past decade. As you have observed, certain topics stand out. Features of Hinduism, view on Buddhism, Hinduism and science similarities, Indian culture in Vivekananda's writings, and features of Vivekananda's addresses. These topics form the backbone of the questions, and here is a golden tip. The pattern of question in IGNU term end exams tends to repeat. You will encounter similar questions based on these topics every time. So prepare yourself to dance with these topics by watching the video till the end and success will be yours. Now let's continue our discussion with features of Hinduism. Swami Vivekanand mentions numerous features of Hinduism. Here are some of them that will give you enough insight to write an answer on this topic in about 5 to 6 pages. Universality of religion. Vivekanand emphasizes the universal nature of Hinduism, portraying it as a religion that recognizes and accepts the validity of diverse spiritual paths. Tolerance and acceptance. Hinduism, according to Vivekanand, embodies a spirit of tolerance and acceptance of various beliefs. He encourages people to respect and understand different religions. Individual spiritual experience. The Swami underscores the importance of individual spiritual experience in Hinduism. He suggests that religion encourages personal exploration and connection with the divine. Rejection of dogma. Hinduism, as presented by Vivekanand, is portrayed as a religion that rejects dogma. It allows for flexibility in beliefs and practices, accommodating various interpretations and approaches. Cyclical view of time. Vivekanand touches upon the Hindu concept of cyclical time, where the universe goes through repeated cycles of creation, preservation, and dissolution. This cyclical perspective influences Hindu attitudes towards life and the cosmos. Inclusivity of various paths. Hinduism, as discussed by Vivekanand, accommodates different yogic paths such as the path of knowledge, the path of devotion, and the path of selfless action. This inclusivity allows individuals to choose a path that suits their temperament. Diversity within unity. Vivekanand stresses the idea that Hinduism embodies diversity within unity. While there is a rich tapestry of beliefs, rituals, and deities, there is an underlying unity that connects all these expressions of spirituality. Social reform and compassion. Vivekanand suggests that Hinduism is not just a set of rituals but a force for social reform and compassion. He points out the historical instances where Hindu saints worked for the welfare of society. Recognition of the divine in all. Hinduism, as described by Vivekanand, recognizes the divine in all beings. This perspective fosters a sense of interconnectedness and a duty to serve and respect all life forms. Adaptability and evolution. According to Vivekanand, Hinduism is not static but dynamic. It has the capacity to adapt and evolve with changing times, making it relevant in different eras. Emphasis on self-realization. The Swami highlights the central theme of self-realization in Hinduism. The ultimate goal is to realize one's true nature and attain union with the divine. These points provide a deeper understanding of how Swami Vivekanand articulated the features of Hinduism in the Parliament of Religions. Now let's move on to another page for discussion on the topic View on Buddhism. Common roots with Hinduism. Vivekanand acknowledges that Buddhism and Hinduism share common origins. He draws parallels between Buddha and Hindu spiritual traditions, highlighting that Buddha was born in a Hindu family and emerged from the cultural and religious milieu of ancient India. Buddha as a Hindu reformer. Swami Vivekanand sees Buddha as a reformer within the broader framework of Hinduism. He emphasizes that Buddha did not intend to start a new religion, but sought to reform existing practices and bring about a moral and spiritual awakening. Fulfillment, not destruction. Vivekanand asserts that Buddha's teachings were not intended to destroy Hinduism, but to fulfill and further develop its spiritual truths. He likens the relationship between Hinduism and Buddhism to that of Judaism and Christianity, where the latter represents a fulfillment of the former. Philosophical differences. While recognizing the commonalities, Vivekanand acknowledges some philosophical differences between Hinduism and Buddhism. He discusses how Buddhist monks struggled against the eternal principles found in the Vedas and how the two traditions had distinct perspectives on metaphysics. Spiritual equality and non-casteism. Vivekanand praises Buddha for his emphasis on spiritual equality. He narrates how Buddha rejected the caste system, allowing individuals from all castes to become monks. This emphasis on spiritual equality had a profound impact on society. Buddha's sympathy for the poor. Vivekanand admires Buddha's compassion, particularly his concern for the poor. He shares an incident where Buddha insisted on teaching in the vernacular language rather than Sanskrit, demonstrating its empathy for the common people. Missionary spirit of Buddha. Vivekanand applauds Buddha for being a pioneer in missionary efforts. He points out that Buddha was the first to actively engage in proselytizing, spreading his teachings beyond the boundaries of his immediate community. Loss and gains from the separation. Vivekanand reflects on the consequences of the separation between Buddhism and Hinduism. While Buddhism brought social reform and compassion, he argues that it also led to a decline in the reforming zeal within Hinduism. Mutual dependence of Hinduism and Buddhism. Vivekanand asserts that Hinduism cannot thrive without the intellectual depth of Buddhism, and Buddhism cannot flourish without the compassionate heart of Hinduism. He sees their separation as a cause for the decline of India. Call for unity. Vivekanand concludes by urging the integration of the intellectual strength of the Brahmin with the compassionate spirit of the great master Buddha. He emphasizes the need for a harmonious union between the two traditions for the well-being of India. These points provide insights into how Swami Vivekanand viewed Buddhism in the context of his addresses at the Parliament of Religions. Now let's jump to the next topic, that is Hinduism and science, similarities. Compatibility with scientific inquiry. Vivekanand emphasizes the compatibility of Hinduism with scientific inquiry. He asserts that Hinduism encourages questioning, exploration, and the pursuit of knowledge, aligning with the scientific spirit of inquiry and discovery. Harmony between religion and science. Swami Vivekanand rejects the notion of an inherent conflict between science and religion. He argues that Hinduism, unlike some other religious traditions, provide a harmonious framework for the coexistence of scientific exploration and spiritual understanding. Rational basis of Hindu beliefs. Vivekanand suggests that Hinduism is not based on blind faith, but is inherently rational. He highlights that Hindu beliefs are open to scrutiny and reason, aligning with the scientific principles of evidence-based inquiry. Unity of knowledge. According to Vivekanand, Hinduism sees knowledge as a unified whole. He draws attention to the interconnectedness of different branches of knowledge within Hindu philosophy, echoing the interdisciplinary approach of modern science. Concept of universal energy. Vivekanand introduces the Hindu concept of prana or universal energy. He suggests that this concept aligns with the modern scientific understanding of energy as a fundamental force that permeates the universe. Cyclical view of time. Hinduism, according to Vivekanand, has a cyclical view of time where the universe undergoes infinite cycles of creation and dissolution. This cyclical perspective bears resemblance to certain scientific theories about the cyclic nature of the cosmos. Evolutionary ideas in Hinduism. Vivekanand touches upon the idea of evolution within Hindu philosophy. While not presenting a detailed scientific theory, he suggests that Hindu thought has a framework that can accommodate the concept of evolution, showcasing compatibility with certain scientific ideas. Encouragement of observation and experience. Hinduism encourages direct observation and personal experience in the pursuit of spiritual truths. Vivekanand argues that this aligns with the scientific method, where observation and empirical evidence are fundamental to the understanding of the natural world. Emphasis on harmony with nature. Vivekanand underscores the Hindu emphasis on living in harmony with nature. This echoes modern ecological and environmental concerns, aligning with scientific perspectives of the importance of sustainability and ecological balance. Dynamic nature of Hindu philosophy. Vivekanand suggests that Hindu philosophy is dynamic and adaptable, capable of evolving with the progress of human knowledge. This adaptability is seen as a strength that resonates with the ever-evolving nature of scientific understanding. These points highlight how Swami Vivekanand presented Hinduism as having inherent similarities with the scientific approach during his addresses at the Parliament of Religions. Next up, we will discuss Indian culture in Vivekanand's writings. Humanitarian values. Vivekanand advocates for the humanitarian values embedded in Indian culture. He shares instances from Indian history and scriptures that underscored compassion, charity, and social welfare. Celebration of diversity. Vivekanand explores the celebration of diversity as a core aspect of Indian culture. He narrates stories or examples that showcase the beauty of diverse traditions coexisting peacefully. Yoga and meditation practices. Swami Vivekanand talks about the emphasis of yoga and meditation in Indian culture. He connects these practices to the development of a balanced and harmonious life. Cultural legacy and heritage. Vivekanand explores the rich cultural legacy and heritage of India. He encourages the audience to appreciate the profound contributions of India to art, literature, philosophy, and more. Modern relevance of ancient wisdom. Vivekanand demonstrates how he sees the modern relevance of ancient Indian wisdom. He quotes instances where he encouraged the application of traditional principles to contemporary challenges. Call for cultural renaissance. He urges for a cultural renaissance to revive the noble aspects of Indian culture. He proposes that embracing these cultural values could lead to individual and societal betterment. Global impact of Indian culture. Vivekanand points out instances where Indian cultural ideas could contribute positively to global conversations on ethics, morality, and holistic living. These points introduce you to the aspects of Indian culture in Vivekanand's writings. Now moving on to the last topic of this video, that is features of Vivekanand's addresses. Universal Brotherhood. Vivekanand passionately advocates for the idea of universal brotherhood. He emphasizes the essential unity of all religions, promoting tolerance and understanding. Religious inclusivity. Vivekanand rejects religious fanaticism and exclusivity. He encourages the assimilation of diverse religious thoughts for collective spiritual progress. Emphasis on the practical spirituality. Vivekanand stresses the practical application of spiritual ideals in daily life. He urges individuals to go beyond ritualistic practices and manifest spirituality in action. Promotion of rational thinking. Swami Vivekanand advocates the harmonization of science and religion. He encourages rational inquiry and the pursuit of knowledge alongside spiritual growth. Social reform and service. Vivekanand advocates for social equality and justice. He highlights the importance of selfless service for societal well-being. Individual empowerment. Vivekanand inspires individuals to recognize their innate divinity. He urges people to break free from mental limitations and strive for self-realization. Patriotism and global citizenship. Vivekanand expresses deep love for his motherland, India. He also calls for a balance between patriotism and a broader global perspective. Optimism and fearlessness. Vivekanand instills a sense of optimism even in challenging times. He encourages fearlessness in the pursuit of truth and righteousness. Practical Vedanta. Vivekanand presents Vedanta as a practical philosophy for daily living. He blends ancient wisdom with contemporary relevance. Appeal for action. Vivekanand calls for proactive engagement in shaping one's destiny. He advocates for individuals to take responsibility for personal and collective progress. These features collectively showcase the richness and depth of Swami Vivekanand's addresses, reflecting his vision for a harmonious world rooted in spirituality, knowledge, and social welfare. As we conclude this guide to addresses at the Parliament of Religions by Swami Vivekanand, set sail with confidence, armed with the wisdom imparted by Vivekanand, and let the light of knowledge guide you to success in your exams. Happy studying, and yes, don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe. See you soon.